A Chinese attempt to stop the evacuation of a sick Filipino soldier from a Philippine naval outpost is denounced by the Philippine Coast Guard as inhumane and barbaric. Bianca Dava has tonight's top story.
This video was taken on board the Philippine Coast Guard's high-speed response boat within the vicinity of Ayungin Shoal in the West Philippine Sea on May 19. The vessel was making its way to the Philippine Navy's rigid hull inflatable boat where it was supposed to fetch a Navy personnel in need of medical attention. PCG spokesperson for the West Philippine Sea, Commodore J. Tarjala, said for over an hour, China Coast Guard vessels and boats repeatedly blocked and harassed the Philippine boats from conducting the medical evacuation. This, despite informing China about the humanitarian mission. At one point, one of the Chinese rubber boats rammed the Navy's inflatable boat carrying the sick personnel.
Last May 18, no, a day before we did the medical evacuation, nakatanggap ang Philippine Coast Guard ng request from the Armed Forces of the Philippines na merong isang personnel, no, on board BRP Sierra Madre that requires medical attention. The Command of the Philippine Coast Guard has decided na mag-deploy kami ng high-speed response boat namin.
Two larger China Coast Guard vessels were also close by. Tarjala called China's obstruction of the medical evacuation barbaric and inhumane.
It just goes to show, no, na whether it's just an ordinary resupply mission or even medical evacuation, na dapat meron na nga silang mas leniency, di ba? Or consideration, dahil this is a humanitarian mission. And yet, they still didn't at least ease the tension, no, in hampering our operation.
Despite the dangerous maneuvers by the Chinese vessels, the PCG and the Philippine Navy were able to complete the mission and transport the sick personnel to the nearest hospital in Palawan. While the Philippine side clearly explained the situation is a medical emergency, the Chinese Foreign Ministry insists advanced notice is needed. A ministry spokesperson also said Manila should not use humanitarian reasons to transport construction materials to Ayungin Shoal. The area has been the site of previous Chinese aggression, the latest being China's seizure of food and other supplies meant for Filipino troops at the naval outpost.
China's position on the issue of the Rinnai Reef is clear. If the Philippines notifies China in advance, we could allow the Philippines to deliver necessary supplies to and evacuate relevant personnel from the beached naval vessel. However, the Philippines may not use this as an excuse to transport materials of construction to its naval vessels in an attempt to permanently occupy Rinnai Reef.
Meanwhile, for the first time, the PCG has documented the launch of a hovercraft by the People's Liberation Army Navy in the West Philippine Sea earlier this week. This took place some 15 to 20 nautical miles away from Escoda Shoal, where the Philippine government was conducting a marine scientific research. Tarjala said the PLA Navy belatedly informed the PCG's BRP Teresa Magbanwa of its intention to conduct amphibious drills off the shoal.
Bago pa sila nag-abiso sa atin na magkakandak sila ng amphibious operation, na i-deploy na nila yung sarili nilang hovercraft.
But more importantly, Tarjala stressed, China has no right to hold drills in the area, which is well within the country's exclusive economic zone. The Philippine Navy had earlier slammed China for conducting a military exercise near the atoll. Defense Secretary Gilberto Chodoro Jr. said he is looking into utilizing the AFP Visayas Command to further strengthen the country's territorial defense capabilities.
Sino bang aggressive? Ang aggressive ang China eh. Kasi wala silang karapatan na to be in there in the first place.
Meanwhile, the AFP said two Chinese warships were monitored in the Zamboanga Peninsula on Thursday. In a statement, the AFP said a PLA Navy training ship and an amphibious transport dock passed through the Basilan Strait. The military immediately deployed the BRP Domingo del Juana to shadow the two Chinese warships. It also issued a radio challenge. One of the vessels responded that it was conducting normal navigation from Timor-Leste to China. The Basilan Strait is recognized as an international sea lane which allows the innocent passage of vessels from various nations. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News.